My name's Alan Hart, and today I'm going to install a new boiler in my own house. So at the moment we've got a boiler that's here, and we want to put a fridge in this cupboard. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to board the wall out behind, and we're going to move the boiler and put it on the back wall. Well, we're going to install a new boiler, but we're going to put it on the back wall. I'm also going to update the system, so I'm going to put it onto two zones. So I'm going to have a nest for upstairs and a nest for downstairs, so that we can control the heating a bit better. I'm also going to put a weather comp sensor on this, so we'll have the weather comp so that in the warmer weather the flow temperatures will be lower, so that'll save us money on those gas bills as well. I've got some zone valves, so we're going to put it onto an S plan. So for an S plan, we will have a zone valve for downstairs, and then we'll have a zone valve for upstairs. And then obviously that's how you would control the heating system, and then you would use the Nest thermostats then to control them. So what I'll do now is I'll show you in this cupboard, and I'll show you what we're going to do. Let's have a look now. So we've also got the gas meter that's in the way here, so we're also going to have that moved as well. So you can just see here what I'm going to do. I'm going to board the wall out at the back there, and then we're going to put the new boiler onto that. I'm also going to power flush this system, so I'm going to connect it onto the old boiler and flush it with the old boiler in place. So as I board the wall out in here, I'm looking at where I put my supports, and I'm looking at the template for the boiler. So this is a Baxi 600 boiler. So it's the new 636 boiler. So I'm just looking where screw holes are, and I'm going to put the supports where that is. So I'm just using the template so I can mark and connect all the pipes together. You see there? Just got his bypass on there. Right, so we've got some up pipes in now. So just to explain what's going on here. So the Baxi 600 has space so you can put the pipes up the back. So what I've got here, we've got his flow there. His flow goes up to there, and then it goes across there, and we've got a bypass because we've got this on an S plan. We've got a bypass, and then that's the return. So then also on bottom there we've got a filter, so we've got a Omega filter on there, so that's the return back into the boiler. And then from the top there, so if we go around the floor, we've got two zones, and then we're just gonna have a air vent, manual air vent up there, just so we can bleed that section of pipework. So I've got one of those zone valves there, and I'm just going to put another zone valve here now. And then just to show you on a zone valve, most of you will know this already, but there's just an A and there's a B. So the zone valve only goes one way, so you need to make sure you put it on the right way around. So on this one, the A comes down from the floor in that direction. So when you look at the valve there, that's the flow would go that way. So we've got the Baxi 636 that we're installing in this house, in my house. So you can buy the pipes from Baxi that are pre-made, that'll come up the back, and you also get this bracket, and that obviously will clip the pipes. And then when you look, so you can put 22 up the back nice and easy there. So now I've pre-marked where I'm putting all the pipes. I've made it up as a template. Because it's press fit, I can now just unclip it off, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the paper back off. And I'm also going to remove the clips off there. They were just to hold it in place while I connected it all together. So I've just lifted the boiler onto the bracket now. So I've just got this filter connected in. Now I've just done cold. I'm just going to do the blow-off pipe. So we're using this new Hilti NPR19A. So that's a 22 volt press gun for this. And I'm just doing gas now. I just want to show you these gas fittings. So the gas fittings has got a yellow o-ring. So I use press fitting on most of my installs. One of the benefits of press fitting is you can make it all up off, away from the boiler if you need to. Also, there's no flux going into the system, so it doesn't take as long to flush the system out after. Also on this, I'm going to put a shock arrestor on. So I've got some Loctite 577. So instead of using PTFE, this is miles better than PTFE. So all you do with this is get your thread and just squirt a little bit on your thread like that. And then once you've got some on your thread, you just tighten it onto your fitting. You see that it actually sucks the liquid into it, and you just tighten it on. You don't actually have to tighten these up. I always would, but you don't have to. And that will seal. And then I'm just gonna get a spanner and just tighten that up, and then I can just wipe off that bit of liquid that's overlapped. So it's really easy to use press fit. So we just get this fitting, look inside. Check that there's O-rings are in. Make sure they're not damaged. Connect it onto the end of this pipe. Some manufacturers will give you, it's like a little instrument that you can use, like a bit of plastic. And then you can mark this pipe here. When we're doing it like this, it's not as important because we know it's not gonna drop off. But say for instance, you had it all in place and you're going to press it all up, one of bits of pipe could have dropped out a little bit. Let's say it's dropped out like that, and then you try and press it, or it could be just on a little bit, and you press it, it might hold to start with. So it's very important that you do mark them, or you are very careful that the fitting is totally in. And then once you push your fitting totally on, you just get your press gun. So that's that fitting now pressed. And we'll just do the rest of the fittings now as well. So we can see on there now, I've just made it all up. And then I can just install it. I've wired the zone valves in now. Just into wiring center there. So I use these wiring centers when I can. Salas ones. I like it where you can get all different wires in like that. And then we've got two nests there, and then I've just temporarily wired one of the nests to the wall here, and I've put the wires there for that charges it. And then other nest is in other room. That's actually wired up, that goes through there. So that's already wired in, that one. I just need to repair that. That's your wiring. If you want to know how to wire one of these, I've done another video and it shows you how to wire them. So I've put my nest upstairs here for the zone upstairs, I've chased the wall out. I've put a bit of decorator's cork in there for now. We're going to get this decorated shortly, so we'll do that polyfiller and sand it down. But that's for us upstairs zone. And this one is for us downstairs zone. So this is in the lounge. So that's the boiler almost installed now. I've just got to fit the Ifos onto this. You can see there. We'll be able to put a fridge in there now because we've got loads of space. And just put a bit of decorator's cork over top of there. And that's for Nest, that goes through to Nest. So we've got our Ifos kit in here. So I'm going to install that into Flue now. I have done a video already on how to install the Ifos. So I'm not going to go over that again now. If you do want to see how to install it, just search for it on YouTube and you'll find a video on how to install it. So customers normally ask me what I would fit if it was my house. So this is what I fitted and this is my house. So what I'll do is I'll show you, I'll have a quick look inside and I'll show you why this is the boiler that I've chosen to fit in my house. Let's have a look inside now. So when we look inside this Baxi 636, so this is the Baxi 600 range of boiler. We've got brass components, it's all brass inside, stainless steel heat exchanger, expansion vessel where we can work on it, shred of valve on top so it's nice and easy to get to. We've got blow off there, so PRV. So if you've got any problems with PRV, you can just undo it from there and just put a new one on. So it's nice and easy. And everything is just easy to work on. So this is why I've chosen this particular boiler for my house. It's also got the Ifos weather compensation on this one. So when we look inside there, we can just see that I've wired it in on there. So when you look in the instructions, the Ifos, it shows you a little chart here and then you can decide what you want to set it for your customer. And then what you do is on there you just change that to whatever curve you decide you want. So I'm going to try it on about 52 for now. So that's about there. So it's quite a high curve. So I'm going to try it on that and see how we go, and then maybe turn it down a bit to a bit lower later on. So that's it, that's your Baxi 600. So that's your 636. And that's all installed now. We've got your two Nest thermostats, one for upstairs and one for downstairs. We've got zone valves, we've got a non-return valve on there and a shock arrestor, and then we've got a Fernox filter. The reason I've chosen that filter is because it's brass and it won't leak later on, so that's why I've chosen that filter, and I think they're a very good filter. So yeah, and that's it, all done. So we've got loads of space now. I've still got that flue to remove. We've just put a bit of expanding foam in for now, just to stop draft coming in. So thank you for taking the time to watch my video. If you've got any questions, please feel free to add them in the comments below. And yeah, thank you.